such a nice day, we thought we'd head outside. We have Rob Spruill, who is the owner of Salisbury Greenhouse, along with Chef Jason Durling, and we're talking about tomato fare. So you brought a bunch of different tomatoes, and we're cooking up something, soup for sure. And what else are we making today?
Today we're going to be making a herb roasted chicken breast with smoked tomato linguine.
Perfect.
And I have my soup boiling away right here.
All right, and the focus is tomatoes because it's that time of year.
Absolutely, it's the time of year when people's tomatoes are ripening on the vine. They're looking delicious, and people are wondering what they can do with them.
Okay, so tell us about Tomato Fair this weekend.
Tomato Fair is a celebration of growing locally and supporting local growers, local farmers markets. Really, in the past few years in gardening, there's been a huge shift towards people wanting to grow their own food. And this is really what this festival is all about. It's this Sunday from 4 to 8 out at Salisbury Greenhouse. And there's going to be over a dozen vendors. There's going to be restaurants. There's going to be local artisans, all based around locally grown food. Mm-hmm. There's going to be locally brewed beer, all sorts of great stuff like that. But the focus on tomatoes in every dish, and just to really emphasize the health benefits and all the benefits of growing your own food.
Okay, so let's start with the soup here. This is a roasted heirloom tomato soup.
Roasted heirloom
so
tomato.
You just roasted tomato.
And rosemary soup.
Okay.
So basically we just take our vegetables and our tomatoes.
Can you pick any vegetable? You've gone with carrots, onions, and celery, but is it personal choice, really?
Personal choice, but basically I went with the basic mirepoix for flavor building purposes.
Okay.
And here we have a bunch of the tomatoes that I do use in the soup, preferably the large ones.
Now, are these all a different variety of tomatoes?
These are different varieties, yeah. We have zebra striped tomatoes,
okay.
Conchita, the yellow, and the red heirlooms.
And the yellow are not ever going to turn red.
They're not supposed
to stay that way. Okay.
Exactly.
So we're learning as we go.
Exactly. We're just going to plate this up. We're just going to put it in the bowl.
Excuse me.
You bet.
Go. You know, people are often very surprised at the variety of tomatoes available. There's so much more.
I would be one
than,
of them for sure.
There's so much more than different sizes of red, and not just a variety of colors and shapes, but also flavors. And it's incredible how many you can grow.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what else is going on? We have, you'd mentioned beer. That's going to get a lot of people's attention.
I did mention that,
yeah. It is, though, a family affair. There's lots of stuff going on.
You know what? It's really made for families. It's a Sunday evening, 4 to 8, so families can come out. You can feed the whole family. It's really very, it's really very affordable to come out. A bit of a taste of Edmonton flair to come out and experiment with different dishes.
Mm-hmm.
And just taste some really delicious local cuisine. I know I was talking to Jason earlier. He's from Delish. And just the idea of cooking local food is just, the health and the fun of it is just, it's just so much you can do.
Okay, so now we're making the herb roasted chicken, which also features tomatoes. You talked about the health benefits of tomatoes.
Yes.
What are some of those?
Well, if you compare a tomato, like some of these in the dish, that you grow in your own garden compared to a tomato that might be grown somewhere else, maybe California, maybe Mexico,
yeah.
It's often green when they ship it, they spray mm-hmm. it with something to turn it red. And the difference in health, the difference in the amount of nutrients is just, it's extreme. It's crazy how many more nutrients a homegrown tomato has.
Mm-hmm. What kind of nutrients do you get from a tomato?
You know what? I knew you'd ask me that. And and I don't know.
Based on color, I think I might say vitamin C.
A lot of vitamin C. There's pretty much a blend of everything in there.
Mm-hmm.
It's just very, very healthy.
Perfect. Okay, so is this local chicken as well?
This is local chicken, absolutely. And I marinated it overnight in olive oil and fresh herbs.
Okay.
And I'm just going to sear it in
the pan. Also locally grown, I assume?
Also locally grown, okay. Yeah. I go to the Strathcona Farmers Market every Saturday and also the downtown market as well to mm-hmm. get a lot of my produce and stuff like that.
Okay, so how do we get the tomatoes into this dish?
The tomatoes into this dish were prepped ahead of time. They were sliced in half and put in a smoker to expose the meat of the inside of the tomatoes and smoke for about 5 or 10 minutes. And I have those here.
Do you have to put a certain type of wood in the smoker? Do you try to go for flavor? Oh, the chef's secret.
I have a special blend, yes.
Now, let's suppose you don't have a smoker. Can you just throw it in your oven and roast them?
You could roast them as well, yeah. With roasting, you're going to dehydrate them a little bit, but with the smoking, with the flesh side up, or the inner meat up, you get all that lovely juice that's on the inside of the tomatoes as well that has all that flavor.
It's amazing how creative you can get with not just with tomatoes, but with local ingredients. The possibilities are endless.
For sure. You may be overestimating my imagination. But it's good to have inspiration like this. Okay, so it runs, as you said, from Sunday from 4 until 8 at Salisbury Greenhouse. Do people need to get tickets in advance? Do they show up? Do they need to register? What do they have to do?
You can buy tickets in advance. They're $15 in advance. And with that, you get $4 worth of tickets for food. So it's a great deal. And that you can buy them at Salisbury, or you can head to the website. The website's on there.
Mm-hmm.
And the website is...
We'll have a link to it from our website as well.
Anyway, you can head there and buy the tickets through there as well, or come to Salisbury, and they're $20 at the door, if not.
Sounds great. Okay, so that's August 14th from 4 to 8. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
We're back right after the break.